Hello everyone, xHedra here, bringing you episode 5 of Exoria, a mod pack by DavQuest. So in the last episode, I finally got all of my trees planted. So now I got a mango tree, and I got a cherry tree, and I think it's a lemon tree back there. This is a boring apple tree, and Minecraft was more boring than apple tree. A banana tree and a coconut tree, and the banana tree is so weird. This basically will extend down and down and down, and it makes banana there. And I think, not quite sure of that, that you have to collect, break it down and collect everything in one go. For the coconut tree, we're going to have to build some ramps up. But I have one coconut here, and is it really all of it? I've got only one coconut, but these trees are renewable, so I'm going to get more than that for sure. Okay, so today we're going to get into masks. Like, we're just going to get into quest, because I want to get to metal as fast as possible. By the way, in my time-lapse, see how you run slowly on this ash block? Now that we have easy cobblestone, my goal is to start replacing the ground with cobblestone so I can walk faster. But like I said in the last episode, I was going to prepare a crap ton of stuff, and that's what I did. So for the concrete, we should be good. Now for concrete, we need, not this, gravel, sand. Oh my god, I'm just taking the wrong things. Gravel, sand, and clay. And if I come here and I say concrete, let's search for concrete. At earthwork, because there's so many concrete, you want the right one from... Oh no, I'm not in the right thing. I didn't pick up the right thing, I'm sure now. Let me just find concrete right here. So it's sand, gravel, and lime plaster. So not the clay, but the lime plaster. Where is it still cooking? Let me just go take a quick look. And nope. No, stone. I always like stone. Let's grab the stone, but no. So lime plaster is somewhere in here. I think it's this one. This one's looking better. Quick lime. So nope. Wait, what do I mean lime plaster? Lime plaster. Oh, it's quick lime and sand. So yes, let's grab the quick lime. Let's grab the sand. That's a 64. And now we're going to need to use the clay bucket. You know what? I want more than one clay bucket. It's just going to be annoying else. So do I have any terra clay clump in here? Yes. And 12 is going to give me 4 buckets. That's too much. I'm just going to make 3. 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. I said 3. Thank you. And let's put this somewhere in here. I'm going to rearrange and clean up everything later. You know me, I'm lazy. And right now I'm just excited about getting these things done. So let's grab some leaves so that we can make some more water. And let's just come back here, kill this, grab water, throw some leaves in. Or not, it doesn't seem to have enough space to claim more leaves. Now we're gonna go back here, and what I'm going to do differently is that usually I use the question mark. The reason I don't wanna use a question mark now is that I can only do one at a time. That's 4, 4, and 4, and 4. Bucket of water right here. That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, and that's going to give me some lime plaster, 8 exactly. And then I can go grab the other buckets to make more lime plaster. Yeah, that's the term. Let's go back here and grab some more water. So 1 bucket, 2 buckets, 3 buckets. Now we should be able to throw some leaf. Really? No. Oh, it's probably broken. I'm going to have to put it down again. So that's one of the annoying reality of this, but it's not the end of the world, so let's just not bother with it too much. Remove this, put this, get it, remove this. I guess I'm missing one sand right here. And get this, and how many is this? It's 40, no, it's 32. You know what, I'm gonna make 64. 1, 2, 3, 4, nope. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey guys, what would you be doing if there wasn't counting with xHedra? For all of you chaps in school, that must be practical. Whenever you have to do homework, you can just count with me. You turn on episode 5 at minute mark 5 and you just start counting with me. Yeah, no, that doesn't sound either fun nor useful, so maybe not the best option of things to do. I just feel, I'm just having so much fun today. I'm loving this pack, everything's going great, my progression was amazing, so I feel like we're gonna get to metal today. Real metal. So let's do this next. And where are my other water buckets? So one, and oh, not you, you. Perfect. So now that we have 64 of each, I should be able to come right here, say concrete, and plug this in and go boom. Just right click, right click, right click, and that's 128 concrete, which completes one quest. Perfect. Next quest is the Foundry. So let's come right here, get rid of these leaves, get rid of these buckets, and is there anything? Yeah, the quicklime and the sand. I still have a lot of quicklime, so that's not going to be a waste. That's going to be useful later. Perfect. So for the next quest, it's already done, but I made sure to never have... I thought I'd made sure to never get 17 and 20 in my hand at the same time, but I guess I wasn't careful enough. So let's grab this copper and that copper and those refractory brick and let's get to it. So I already know what I want to make, so I'm going to need 11 copper plate and I already have one, so let's just go like this and then we'll just hit this until we get to 11 copper plate. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11, and you don't hit, if you hit it with the hammer, it's gonna put another ingot. If you don't, you're going to be fine. So perfect. And now, so we have the copper plate. I need two more furnace. Are they the real furnace though? Let's just search for smelter, smeltery. Wow, okay. I don't remember the term, just give me a second. Burner heater right here. So it's a standard furnace. Perfect. So I just need some cobblestone. Let's go grab some cobblestone right here. And I'm gonna make two furnace. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Perfect. So now that I have the two furnace, I'm gonna need two refractory casing and a copper cauldron. So the copper cauldron, how is the copper cauldron made again? Let's just search for it. So copper cauldron is made from copper, or yeah, just plain basic copper. So let's just do that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Grab that. Perfect. Then we need the refractory casing, but I'm gonna do those when I'm ready. What else do I wanna prep? I'm gonna need some grout. I don't remember the recipe for grout. So grout was gravel, clay. Ooh, I prefer this recipe. So gravel, sand, and clay. So I'm gonna want to make, let's say 32. So that's 4 craft. So 4 times 4, that's 16. So I need 16 gravel. Do I still have the gravel on me? New. Where's the gravel? I'm gonna need the clay. Gonna need some sand block. You know what? The easy way to get sand block is just to grab, oh, not this one. I'm gonna grab a stack of 64 and I'm gonna make 64 sand. Oh, 16, not 64. And I need 64 gravel. Do I have stones at least? I don't wanna bother with this right now. Yeah, I got 64 stone, which is gonna give me 60 gravel. And now it should be good to make the clay, the grout, sorry. So if I come here, that's 16, and that's 32. Let's get rid of this, and we're going to start cooking the grout. And what I'm going to do with the grout is I'm going to split it in two. So 16 in here, 16 in here, and now let's get to the quest. So the quest wants us to make a burner heater, a melting crucible, a mold crafting station, and a faucet. So let's go with melting crucible first. So melting crucible and burner heater. I don't know why that's coming up, but good. So the burner heater needs a refractory casing, and the melting crucible needs a refractory casing. Refractory casing is 4 brick with 4 copper plate. So how many are those? I just need that to make sure. That should be 2. Sorry. Perfect. And oh, I'm good. Now I can craft everything. So I can craft a burner heater. Let's just make sure that I'm making only one. I don't want to... see? I would have derped this if I did it this way. We also need a melting crucible. Do need to hit the question mark, though. So a melting crucible. Perfect. So that's 2 part of the quest. We need a mold crafting station. Let's get rid of this. And let's look at... Wait, what? Burner heater. I never crafted the other part. The melting crucible needs a refractory key. What happened here? Do I not have... Where is my copper cauldron? Hello? I feel like I lost my copper cauldron. Burner heater is just this. Did I not make a copper cauldron? You know what? I'm really sure I made one, but I don't want to waste the time right now. And what's going to happen is I'm going to watch this in post when I'm editing the video, and I'm going to find exactly what I screwed up, and I'm going to be pissed. But I don't see it, and you know what? Worst case scenario, I have enough copper that it doesn't matter. So let's make this, and now we should be able to make the melting crucible. No! What is this? I already have it. How do I have an extra furnace, though? See, that I can't explain to myself, because this needed a furnace, and oh, this didn't. Oh well, this copper cauldron is a beautiful derp brought to you by xHedra. Always with the derp. So, mold station. Oh boy, mold crafting station. I'm gonna need a crafting table and... Oh yes, perfect. Okay, so next important thing to know. The mold crafting station requires a stone slab. Stone slab can be made with a handsaw. But not a flint handsaw. It needs at least a quartz or copper or iron or quartz. Or you can also do it with diamond or emerald, but we're not there yet. So the copper, which is the only one we can make yet, is light copper plate and this. So that's why I made these extra 2 light copper plates. So copper plate, and then for the sticks, we need sticks and sticks. And I don't know if I have a little widget, gadget, something. I never remember the name of that thing. This is rock. Do I have any left? I don't know why I bother. Let's just grab this and go like this. Make some stick and... Oh! It actually does help if you do make the sticks. So you make the sticks and now use my old flint and saw to make some more wood pins. And that's the only thing that was missing, a wood pin. So let's go back here and use the wood pin right here. And that gives us a copper handsaw. Now with a copper handsaw, I can cut some stone into some stone slab. We're going to need a couple of stone slab, I think. So let's just make 12 for now. I'm pretty sure that's going to be too many, but at least I have them. And now we need a crafting table, and we have the furnace. So crafting table like so. And we should be able to click that in. So let's grab the mold crafting station, like so. We're gonna put this down right here. And I'm gonna show you how this works. So first we need some more refractory clay. So we need more of this. Perfect, so I'm going to make 8, 16, I want 16. So I'm gonna need two craft of this, so four clay and two sand. Four clay and two sand, that shouldn't be a problem. Like I said, I prepared so much material that everything is good. So, one, two, three, four clay. Put it right here. And the sand, I only need two, so that's going to be one and two. And put that back here, like so. And now the important part is you don't want refractory clay. You want refractory clay block. And oh, I forgot to make the faucet. Let's just make the faucet first and then I'll continue with my explanation. So for the faucet, we need seared brick like this. One, two, three. That gives us a faucet and that's a quest completed. Now that the quest is completed, next step is heavy metal. Heavy metal. Now I can finally cast any of the metals I gathered. I will need a way to make blocks, ingots, and plates for now. So ingots, plate, and block, casting table. So what we're going to do is search casting table. And there are four casting table. It only wants us to make the ingot, the plate, and the block. But I know that I'm going to need the rod anyway. So I figured I was going to do all four at the same time. And basically the ingot needs an ingot mold, and the plate needs a plate mold, and the rod needs a rod mold, and a block needs a block mold. So how do you make those? The ingot mold is made in a mold station like this, where you see these are all the square that you can do, and then when you mouse over, these are depth 0, these are depth 2. So let's come here, and we're going to, that's why I needed 4, I'm going to put 1 here, and now you see this pattern. So I go depth 1, depth 2. So 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, and 2. So this is ready to craft. I do need some charcoal. So let's grab one charcoal and put it in here. And I can say fire the mold. So it's going to cook this. While this is cooking, I'm going to look at the rod one now. The rod one needs the second line all depth 1. So now that it's ready, I'm just going to try to hurry this up because I still have the cooking. So all depth 1, is it, just make sure, no, it's the second one, so you can right click to remove, so third one, all depth 1, and cook it. And if you choose a recipe that's not good, I think it breaks, you lose the clay block, but it really doesn't matter all that much. So the plate is all of the center depth 1, so now this is done, I'm going to put another one, all of the center depth 1. And go. And the last one, which is the block. The block is everything depth 4. So it's the biggest you can make. And perfect. So now let's put the last one. And you can't go further than 4. So you can just mask click this until you get to depth 4. And basically just get around to all of this. But I'm not going to get it on time. I'm going to have to spend an extra charcoal. And 2 charcoal to make all of this these mold is not that expensive, so it really doesn't matter. It's just, I wish that there was a better way to click this, like that I could multi-select or something, because this mold is the most annoying one to make. You have to go to depth 4 and just click like a crazy person. Finally, it's done. So let's put this and fire this mold. And while we're waiting for this, I'm just going to start working on the next part. So all of the molds are made the same way. Slab and refractory brick on each side. So I'm going to need 4 slab. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then where are the refractory brick? That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's put this one and grab it. And then, oh, not this, 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 and this one. This one, grab it, this one, grab it, and finally this one and grab it, and that should be a quest. If I wait for it to be detected, but now it wants a tin plate. So let's look at this. Now, there's also this one that we can do. So let's do some casting channel. The casting channel are very simple, same seared brick, but you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and that gives you 3. So that's another quest done. And like I told you guys, I was ready. So it's quest, quest, quest. Now this one is kind of stuck. It's going to unlock this. We can also make the resting for sure. But let's take a quick break from this first. So I'm not going to need any more stone slab. Let's put those there. I'm not going to need any cobblestone. Let's put that there. I want to keep those on me. I don't need the stone, the wood, or this. I'll be right back, guys. Sorry. So I guess I'm not that used to the interruption. I thought I was getting a good rhythm, but then the next episode it happens that I get disturbed again. So let me just get rid of this and get rid of that. And now we're kind of stuck. Well, stuck. We're not stuck. What am I talking about? Let's just make the bed quickly because I know I can make the bed. So first, we're going to look for string. And string is make like this. And now 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 2, 3. That's going to give me 3 wool, and I can go wool, wool, wool. Let's get rid of the string right here. Let's get rid of the industrial hemp fiber right here. Let's grab the wood that I should have kept on me and go and, oh, wait a minute. Bed? How do I make the bed? It's planks and white wool. How is that not a... Oh, yes, it is a bed. Whew. I thought I was screwing myself up and this wasn't going to work. So the bed is made, which is another quest completed. So now I need to set up the foundry. To be able to cast metal, I need to really work on setting up the foundry. So let's go and put this in here and grab these two shovels. And I want to put my foundry... I'd honestly like to put my foundry right next to this room, but... I don't really have place here, and I kind of decided that this side was going to be the field, so I don't really have any place there either. Which kind of leaves me in a quandary as to where to put the foundry. I don't want to waste too much time on this, but I'd like to have a good spot. You know what? This whole place in here is going to be really... like useless. I'm not gonna break this all down. So let's just start and put it right here. And let's break this face. And we're going to go from the corner here, and I'm gonna work from the corner right here. Let's grab some concrete and I'm going to open this up a little bit more. And I'm gonna put a door in the corner because you know what? The corner's kind of a waste anyway, so I might as well put the door right there and expand the room from there. So I'm going to want this face to be concrete. So let's just, I don't know how far I want to go. Let's start with this concrete. I'm going to need a door for sure. I just forgot to grab it. And we're going to put the door, as I said, in the corner right here. So like this, let's go grab the door, and I'm going to have to transform a little bit of this ash. See, that's the only boring thing with the ash, that it breaks into so many items that you're always, your inventory is always like over full with ash that you have to get rid of. So let's just put this right here. And do I have a door? Yeah, I still have 2 doors right here, but I only need 1. Let me put this here. Oh. And I'm gonna put 1 door back and keep that 1 door. I'm also going to want some plate, but you know what? That can wait later. And I got torches right here, so that's good. Let's put a door that we're going to open and let's get in there. Perfect. So now that we can go in here, this is where our concrete room is going to be for now. So I need this to be kind of big. Not too big, let's not exaggerate thing, but it has to be big enough to at least have 64 concrete exposed. So I'm just going to make this a bit bigger, and you know what? I'm going to make the floor out of concrete because having to walk on the ash is getting to me. It's really annoying how it slows everything down. So let's go and break. Ah, that broke the door. Really? Don't tell me. Did I lose the door? I have another one, but yeah, this is so weird in this mod pack. In this mod pack, if you bury something, you kind of lose it. So let's just continue. We have another door, which is a good thing, but let's continue opening this right here. And I'm going to lose some ash and ask me if I care. Not at all. Not even a little bit. It's not like we don't have a crazy crap ton of ash. So let's continue expanding this room. Because I haven't even used 64 yet. I know based on the fact that it's in my hand, I still have 19 from the first stack. And I wish I had built this room, well, I had made this room enough, sorry, not, how can I say this? I wish I had prepared that space in the room before, but I guess I was running out of time. I made the last time lapse really long, but I really wanted to get a lot of stuff done. So let's just continue with this. And I think that after that, it's going to be big enough that I can start working on the foundry and not waste any more time on this. So let's just quickly finish this. I'm trying to occupy the empty space with my voice, my beautiful, lovely voice. Perfect. So let's go like this. And now I have 64. Let's go to the next packet of concrete. Perfect, so that's enough exposed concrete that I shouldn't have a problem. So now I can start setting up the foundry. Let's put a torch right here. Let's put a torch right here, and we're going to put the foundry in the middle. So first you need the burner heater on the ground, like so. On top of it, you put the melting crucible. Let's go grab a door first. Without a door, nothing works in this game. So let's just go grab a door quickly. Oh, that's my door. And let's close it. Now we can put the melting crucible on top. And, oh, I only made one faucet. So let's put the faucet right there, but I want more than one because the reason I put it in the middle like this is that here's what I want to do. Put this here, put this here, put this here, and no, the ingot is the most useful one, and this is probably the least useful one. So we're going to put the block one in the back, and we're going to put the ingot right here. And now I'm going to go grab some charcoal, and we're going to go grab some more faucet. So I want three more faucet. So that's going to be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Grab all of that. And I'm going to grab some tin. Is that the tin? Yeah, tin or rock. And let's go back here. Nope, I forgot the charcoal. See, do you see how much faster I move without the, when I don't have to be on the ground? I really want to replace this with cobblestone, but again, it's everything is a question of time in this mod pack. So first we're gonna put charcoal in here, and while this is eating up, we're going to put a faucet here, faucet here, and faucet here. Perfect, so now we can cast for all from all four sides. And okay, let's start with the tin. We want a tin plate, so let's just go, I'm going to make three tin plate. So that's 9 to an ingot, and the plate are 1 ingot, so I'm going to need 9, 18, 27, and that's what I'm going to melt first. I don't want to over-melt tin because I don't want to be stuck, and tin has a very low melting point, so this is going to go fast. And now that tin is melting in here, I can right-click and get one plate. And while we're waiting for this, I'm going to start the second one in a moment. And we're going to get some iron now. Always close the door because these machines don't work while the door is not closed. Like, you have to always remember this. This is a real problem. If the door's open, the machine's not working. I'm going to grab some iron because iron is more important. Let's just get rid of these ash block and this ash. And what else did I, oh yeah, I want some wood. That's one wood, I don't care. So let's grab this and go, where's my flint hatchet? So that's two, that's four, and we can get rid of the wood. Sorry about that. And now I'm gonna make one, two. These are the pressure plates that I've put everywhere else, so I don't have to deal with this crap. Then I can do this, and always be okay. Perfect, so this one's ready. I'm casting the third one, and now I'm gonna fill this with iron because the next important metal is going to be iron. So by getting the third plate, I completed this quest with the third tin plate, and I've opened 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more quests. Bucket. Now that I have access to basic metals, I should have a way to make a better bucket. From tin plates, I can now finally make a bucket, which should help moving those hot metal fluids. And do you see those console command? This is going to unlock some new quest line. So let's grab this third plate. And while this is melting, we'll leave this alone and we'll come back. We're going to go and make ourselves our first real bucket. One that can carry lava without a problem. So one, two, three, et voila, a nice little bucket. I'm gonna get rid of this copper. Ooh, you've unlocked sieving knowledge. And anything else? No, so I don't know what else it the other command did, but we unlocked magical life recently. I don't even remember when. And we unlocked resource automation, which is going to bring us into sieving for other different type of resource. Not gonna do that today. Today I'm really going to concentrate on trying to get as far as possible in here, but you know where this is now going. So the other quests that are open are efficiency. With iron, I have access to more efficient tools and items. An iron axe should double the yield from the chopping block, and an iron strainer net should last way longer. So now we need to craft an iron axe and a solid survivalist strainer and a solid survivalist strainer dense. So if I look at these strainers, these are going to cost a standard net and 4 iron and iron bars. And this one, same thing, but with a dense net. And when you look at the bars are made from iron rod. That's why I wanted the rod mold, even though it doesn't request it, because now I need to make 6 iron rod. And once I have 6 iron rod, I need 8 iron ingot. Well, I need more than 8 iron ingot because I also want an iron axe. And the iron axe is what? It's 3 iron ingot. Let's go see if I have at least 3 iron ingot right now so that I could craft the axe, because I want to show that to you guys. So right now we have, I think we have exactly 3 ingots. So let's do that right now. They take a little while. Like I find that this process is a bit long, but what can I do? Until I start putting some hoppers and semi-automating all of this, I'm going to be stuck with the speed. So that's 1. Oh, sorry. That's going to be 2. And I don't even have enough yet. That's going to be my 3rd one. And is this one ready? Hello. Let's melt the 3rd one. That's going to be my 3rd and final one. And we should be good to go and craft our first axe. And having 4 planks and 4 stick per is a major difference. So let's go back here. We're going to grab some wood because I don't have enough stick. I have to put this down and get only 2 sticks from this. And now if I put 1, 2 sticks and 3 iron ingot like this, I get an iron axe. And now I'm going to retire this right here. Now look at this. Let me grab some wood. I'm going to grab some wood. And oh, I'm going to keep this right here and put this in my offhand. Sorry. So if I go right click and chop, that's 4 wood at a time. So that's way more efficient. And now I'm going to remove this and I'm going to put 4 of these in my offhand. And if I go like this, that's 4 stick, another 4 stick, another 4 stick, and voila. So that's a lot more resource. This is going to make everything that much simpler. So it's a good thing that we're finally at that point, because I'm kind of tired of the flint and how fast it breaks. And not only how fast it breaks, but how little resource it gives you. Unfortunately, I still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 flint axe. So I probably overcrafted this. The other thing that we want to do is an adobe crafter. And adobe is why I needed the thatching. I couldn't remember before, but now when I saw that quest, I remember. I have now metal ingots and plates, but I should work toward getting gears. It seems that this process is a little bit harder to achieve. I need a more heat-resistant material in adobe. I wonder if I could use the rush seed that I have to get some thatching. Another way would be probably to use grass. To make the adobe brick mix, I need to dry the thatching on the drying rack I have. To form the mix, I should craft brick forms from split logs. To get them, I need to cut the bark from logs with a work blade by shift right clicking, and then some kind of axe or hatchet can split the stripped log by right clicking. That's a lot of instruction. Putting the brick mix into form now only requires waiting. I should parallelize to speed up and also make sure it's safe from rain. With dry brick, I can now craft adobe block. So let's come right here and see how much thatching that we have. We have 24. I'm gonna grab just 8 for now, and I'm gonna put the other right there. I'm gonna go put this in the drying rack, and then we're gonna get to the next step. So drying rack, 4 in here, and now we need our work blade right here. And with the work blade, we can shift right click, and we remove the bark from the tree, like so. Let's just break this. Sometimes it's the first try, sometimes it's more. And now with the iron axe, you can chop this down. Ooh, am I doing the right thing? Yes, oak strip logs. Oh no. Wait, let me just read again what it wants. To get them, I need to cut the bark from another kind of axe or hatchet can split by right clicking. No. Let's put that all back up because that's not how I want to do it. I don't want to click it. I want to right click it. So you hear the different sound, and now that gives me a different kind of wood, which is the split oak log. Let's R click on that. And the split oak log can be used to make oak log stack or those brick forms. So I want to make 4 brick form. So I'm going to need 8, 16, 32. And how many do I have? 21. So I still need some more. Let's use the work blade on these. Perfect. Where's my work blade? Work blade. Is it dead? No, okay. But it's about to die, so I'm going to have to replace it. So shift right click. Wow. Sometimes it's like 20 click. I'm probably going to need another work blade. And of course, the moment I said that, I needed it. So that's 41. I don't even care though, because the 41 is just enough to make the forms that I want to make. So I'm going to go, you know what? Let's just search for it. Form like this, brick form. And let's get these 4. Wait, 4 or 5? How many did I make? 5. Eek. Okay, too many. It doesn't matter. But before we go, let's grab some more adobe. Oh, some thatching, and let's make some adobe. So this is dried. I'm going to put some more. And now let's look for adobe brick mix. This is what we want to make. It needs a dry thatch, and it needs a refractory clay, and it needs some mud ball. Ooh, refractory clay. I'm going to need to make some more of that. So I'm going to make 8 craft of this. I'm going to need 8 mud ball and 8 dry thatching and 8 refractory clay, so it's 1 craft. So it shouldn't be a problem. I'm just waiting here because I don't want to travel back and forth. Hello. Dry thatching. Perfect. So let's go back here, and I'm going to need 2 clay. Where's my clay? Right here. Oh, how many are these? Oh, just 1. That really doesn't matter. So let's just grab 2. You know what? I think I'm gonna need more adobe. So let's just do 16 right now. I'll make some more dry thatching later. And that's 16 mud ball. And we're going to grab 8 more fresh thatching. That is not what I wanted to do. Let's put that right here. Let's get rid of the dried bark. It's not like I need it right now. We're gonna go back in this room. Get some more thatching right here, and we're going to make this mix. Oh, the refractory clay first. Ah, I need a sand. Derp, I need 2 sand. It's crazy. I just keep forgetting steps. So let's just grab 2 sand, like so. Wow, this is weird. It was in my hand, but it wasn't in my hand. Whatever. Let's come back here, and let's just do some adobe brick mix. No, first this one. Maybe I'll get it in the right order this time. Grab all of this, start the next 4 one, and now we can make the adobe brick mix. Oh, that's 44. It's gonna be 48. And I'm not waiting for this because the next step is gonna take a while, so we're gonna have time to come back. I'm gonna set up my brick mix in this building. Why? No reason particular. I just want to put them here. And what you do is you put these on the ground like this. And now you put Adobe Brick Mix in each of them. And this is going to take a long while to dry. While this is done, let's look at... Room is missing. Ah! That's kind of the problem. Is it's a weird mechanism. And now because I put this down, I kind of covered this. So now I need more. Let's just add some more. I have some in my inventory, so it's not a problem. And just to make sure, I think I also need to get these three. Is it enough? Yes, and all of the iron, wow. So let's start one of the rod because we need 6 rod, and let's go grab more iron because we've been filling the strainer base and we have a lot more iron. So if I come back here, 64 and another 64, you know, that's enough. Let's just go back right here. And let's put the 64 more in here. And that's 1 rod. That's going to be 2 rod, 3 rod, 5 rod, 6 rod, 12 rod, 20 rod. We're going to get all of the rod. But to complete this quest, we need 4 dry adobe brick, which is going to give us adobe. Because the adobe is made from 4 adobe brick. Okay? And let me just grab the next one. I just don't want to get stopped. I also need the ingot, but now the iron's not following. I'm going to need a hopper here because I can't be dealing with always being here and always be casting. Perfect. So let's continue that. Okay. So we need to make the dry adobe, but we're not going to finish it this episode. And for this here, we need to make those strainer. And I've already shown you how to make the strainer. What I want to do before I continue is 2 more rod. Do I have enough metal for it? I think I'm going to be okay. So let's make another rod. That's going to give me 6 rod. And the only reason I want another 6 rod is that I can show you how to make, I can show you. It's not that complicated. It's not like I really need to show you, but since it's not a standard Minecraft recipe, I just wanted to make this process with you. So that gives me the 16 of these iron bars. And now that I have the 16 iron bar, I unfortunately converted all of these. So I'm going to have to do it in my time lapse. So in my time lapse, I'm going to... Can I make just one? I have 8. Yes. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's make this one. Let's go get rid of these. And I'm also going to get rid of the peg. So this, if you remember, can be turned into a survivalist trainer that has 180 use. But if I put this here and I go iron bar all around and iron ingot. Oh, I need 2 more iron ingot. I thought I had enough to make one. I just wanted to make one of the 2 to show you. So if I come here, I need 2 more ingots. These are not close to ready. They take kind of a ridiculous amount of time. That's why I wanted 4. Because 4 at least is 2 sets of bricks. Perfect. So I have my iron. Let's refill this. Always make sure that it's full. And we should be able now to craft that one strainer. So 2 more. Which gives me a solid survivalist strainer. And now look at this. 1,440 uses. And plus 10 efficiency. So, not the same thing. If you look into this one, which is 180 and no extra use, or this one, which is a 1440 and 10 efficiency, look at this one. Reinforced survivalist strainer with some diamonds and some transparent obsidian is going to give us 8,000 use and 25% efficiency, and it's enchantable to make put luck on it. So that's going to be amazing. Let's go back here, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this one in here, and now this should start producing way more. I'm going to have to empty this in my time lapse. So in my time lapse, I'm going to craft the solid survivalist strainer because I want to get that part done. I'm going to make some more adobe brick so that I have enough because adobe is going to be something we need a lot in the future. And I'm going to get material ready. And the next episode is going to get us our first chest. So Crater 8, you were talking about why am I not using standard chest? Because here's the problem. A standard chest needs a nugget or an iron ore berry. And if you look at the nuggets, look at how expensive it is. I can take an iron axe, which cost me 3 full iron, and cook it into a nugget. But there's no uncrafting recipe for nuggets. So this is really complicated, unless we get to the metal caster. And the metal caster is the solution with the nugget mold. But if I look at the metal caster is basically a refractory casing, which is 4 adobe and iron plate. We now have iron plate, no problem. And then it's 2 more adobe, and it's 2 chests. So I'm going to have to make 2 of the old chest and 4 more iron plate. So that's what I want to do. In my time lapse, I want to gather 8 iron plate. I want to gather 6 adobe. And I want to craft 2 chests. 2 regular chests. Well, the bad chest. The one that I hate with the pins and the hopper and whatnot. But at least I'm going to be able to craft the metal caster. And once I have the metal caster, it's just going to be a question of making the nugget mold. So if I look at the mold, the nugget mold is the same principle as all the other one. You basically make this little design, and we're going to get a nugget mold. We're going to be able to cast some iron nuggets, and we're going to be able to make these mold. So in the next episode, like I said, I want to clean up this quest line. In the next episode, we're going to finish everything for grinding my gear in Adobe. I'm going to gather all of the material that we need. I'm going to be in my time lapse crafting the solid survivalist gear. I'm going to prepare everything for the watering can. Can I make the watering can? Can I finish on this watering can? It's really not that useful, unfortunately. It's cool, but not useful. So it's 4 copper. Yeah, I have a bucket and I have 4 copper. So I can just at least clean up another more quest. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and my bucket, and grab this. The reason I say it's not that useful is that, first of all, it steals the water. And I'm not joking. What I mean by that is that if you shift right click. If you right click, it takes the water. So see how the tank is almost empty now? And it doesn't grow all that well. Because if I come back here and you look at this, and I right click, it's not watering all that much. Like, it's not making the crop grow super fast. See, like, I'm in the same spot, and oh, this finally grew. This grew. And look, it's already empty. Watering can is finished. I need to refill it. So if I really needed some kind of material, it might be worth it to use it. But it empties so fast that I find that it's more annoying than it's useful. I'm just going to put it there and retire it for now. At least it's another quest done, which means that in the next episode, we're going to finally craft the piping, because since we're going to be able to make real chests, now it's going to be worth piping out of those, because piping out of those into these chests, it's a nightmare, because they only have 16 space, and most of these can get more than 16 different things. And once it's full, it overflows and it drops on the ground, so I prefer having the regular chest. And then we're going to be able to finish Adobe Crafter and grinding my gears and finally make chests. And now that we can melt metal, I'm not sure I'm going to have time to do it in my time lapse. But in my time lapse, I would like to get 2 iron ore, 2 gold ingot, 2 copper. Well, I already have the copper ingot, sorry. 2 tin ingot, 2 lead ingot, and 2 silver ingot, so that I can grab the fruit and prepare. So that in the next episode, we can throw all of these in. So I think it's doable, and in next episode we can finish all of this and finally move on to either magical life or resource automation, or, as you know me, probably both at the same time, because I'm done with the let's finish a whole quest line before we do the next one, because I want to progress as fast as possible. Guys, I don't know what you think about the series, but I love it. I find that this mod pack is exciting. I can't wait to get off this planet and see the story progress and where I can go. And I'm having a lot of fun. So I think I'm going to maybe try to do... that was a bad idea. I'm thinking I might try to do 2 or 3 episodes in a row this weekend, just to be able to progress Not that I'm dropping the other series, don't worry, I'm not dropping it. But just so I can progress faster. See, this is still not ready. And, oh, this is going to need some more liquid iron. And probably some more charcoal, so I have a lot of things to do in my time-lapse. But I wanted to finish the time-lapse here so you can see this great progression. But we've come to the age of metallurgy, and we can get all of the metal that we want. Guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye now!